Bonsoir à tous. Alors, merci à tous et bienvenue de nous retrouver pour cette plénière inaugurale de la semaine économique du Maroc.
The Economical Week of
Et
Morocco.
j'ai essayé, comme vous le
I will
savez,
try,
les modérateurs sont très souvent
as you know, the moderators
des panélistes
are
frustrés. Je vais
sometimes
utiliser mon joker dès le début pour vous
frustrated
parler du
panelists.
Maroc. Alors,
So
si
I
vous voulez
will
bien, on peut
set
commencer avec nos relations
the stage
avec cette nation marocaine qui est
and
assez
talk
exceptionnelle,
about
absolument
the
exceptionnelle.
Morocco.
Mesdames et messieurs, nous, Marocains, aimons à penser que nous sommes le centre du monde.
Think
C'est
that we are the
peut-être
center of the
un peu
world.
l'esprit de cet
Maybe
État-nation
this
millénaire,
is how we are.
mais la réalité, c'est que
Maybe this
l'histoire,
is
comme la
how
géographie, sont en train de
our
nous donner
youth
raison.
are, but history and
Voilà donc
geography
un pays
are
qui se
only
trouve
proving
à
us
5 000
right.
kilomètres de la
So
capitale
this
la plus
is
au nord
a
de l'Europe,
country
à
who finds
6 000
itself
à 6 000
very
kilomètres de
close
la côte est
to
américaine,
Europe,
à
at
6 000 kilomètres de Dubaï,
6,000
où nous nous trouvons
kilometers
aujourd'hui,
of the
et à 6
USA
000
and of
kilomètres de la
Dubai,
Centrafrique,
and from
du cœur
Central
battant de ce
Africa.
continent qui
The
est l'auto de
heartbeat of this
l'humanité.
continent, who
Pourquoi est-ce que c'est
is
important pour le sujet du jour? C'est parce
very
qu'aujourd'hui, le
important for
Maroc
humanity. Why
déploie sa
are we
nouvelle
doing
ambition
this? Because
et déploie
Morocco
sa nouvelle
is
ambition après une
deploying
séquence qui a
its
été
new
qualifiée
ambition after a
d'exemplaire par un
sequence
groupe
that
d'observateurs
was qualified
internationaux.
as
Je rappelle que le Maroc a
extraordinary.
réussi
Remember
à
that
tenir depuis
Morocco
quelques pays,
has
à
contained the
déployer un filet
COVID-19
sanitaire
pandemic
immense,
and
à mobiliser près
deployed
de 10%
efforts.
de son PIB
It
au plan Maroc
has
qui va être lancé en dehors
10%
des
increase on
conjoncturels.
its
Il a surtout
GDP
réussi
and
une
has
mobilisation
won
sans
to
précédent
mobilize
du secteur privé,
like
du
no
secteur
one
public.
before the
Tout
private
ceci
and the public
intervient à la fin d'une
sector.
séquence
All
très
this
importante au
is
plan industriel.
happening at the
Le Maroc
very
produit
important
aujourd'hui au
industrial
niveau mondial
phase.
700 000
Today
véhicules
we
par an,
have 700, we're producing
dispose du plus
700
grand port de la
vehicles. We
Méditerranée,
have
d'un
the
aéroport
biggest
mondial,
port of
d'accords de
the
libre-échange
Mediterranean.
qui
We
couvrent plus
have
de
the
50
free
pays.
exchange
Et aussi,
agreements
le
with more
Maroc est
than
devenu
50
un leader dans le
countries, and
secteur des
Morocco
services
became a
internationaux et
leader in
financiers,
service sectors, especially
étant le
financial
deuxième
sectors,
investisseur
and
privé
the
en Afrique
second
et le
private
premier
investor in
en Afrique de
Africa, and
l'Ouest.
the first one
Pour
in Western
discuter de tous ces
Africa. To
sujets,
discuss about
comme
all
vous le
these
savez, le
subjects,
Maroc
as you
est un
know,
pays
Morocco
où la
is a
parité et
country
l'inclusion
where
sont
the
devenues
priority,
l'alpha et
the
l'oméga de toutes
inclusion
politiques publiques et
are
privées. Nous
inside
allons avoir un
every
panel assez exceptionnel et
politics.
totalement
We have
paritaire
an
qui couvre
exceptional panel
tous les
that
secteurs
covers all
d'intérêt
the
et tous
sectors
les secteurs
of
sur lesquels le
interest and
Maroc
all the
ambitionne
sectors
de
where
prendre des engagements
Morocco
forts. Ça
is
s'appelle
ambition
Coca-Cola.
to
Sans attendre,
promote
mesdames et
Morocco
messieurs,
now
je vous
its new
demandais de bien vouloir
brand. Without
accueillir
further
nos
ado,
six
I'd
panélistes
like to please ask you
sous
to
un tonnerre
welcome
d'applaudissements
our
pour leur prestation réussie.
panelists. Please applaud them as hard as you can.
Wow! Ils sont beaux, hein? Je pense que vous pouvez les applaudir encore une
They're
fois.
nice. I think you can applaud them one more time.
Alors, si vous voulez bien, on va repasser la
So
musique du jingle, on
we
va remettre
will
à la régie
go
de
back
repasser, parce que c'est une
to the
musique que vous avez tous
jingle
entendue
because it's a
parler, mais
music
c'est pas
that
vraiment
you
une
have
musique
all
que
heard,
vous
but
pouvez
it's not a
appréhender
music.
secrètement. On va
It's
partager
a
ce moment
little
ensemble pleinement
secret
alors on va
that
l'écouter.
we will be
On va l'écouter
sharing
tout
with
de même.
you very shortly. Could you please play the music?
Et donc cette chanson,
So
elle va peut-être
this
n'est pas
thing
véritablement une
is
chanson, en
not
vérité c'est
this song is not
un
really a song.
hymne
It's an
sentiment
emblem.
militaire
It came out
et
in
en démonstration de cette
2004. It's
capacité du Maroc à
emblematic of
pouvoir
this capacity
mobiliser
of
des racines
Morocco to be able to
ancestrales avec communauté
mobilize
privée à ce moment dans
the
ce
history
document
to
brut
the
d'unité
future,
publique au monde, Unita
where
Brothers,
the biggest
choisit
group in
de
the world, Chemical
mélanger cette musique avec
Brothers,
la
chose
musique
to
populaire
mix
marocaine
its
tradie.
music with
Ça donne
Najat
cette
Atiabou, a
identité.
very famous
Je pense que c'est un des plus beaux
singer
symboles du
and
Maroc aujourd'hui, à la fois
in
des
Morocco,
racines du Maroc
and
profond
it
et une attitude
is
très
really
industrielle
important
et
because
souveraine.
it's a mix
Mesdames,
between the
Messieurs,
past and the
nous
future.
avons aujourd'hui
Ladies and
pour
gentlemen,
examiner
today,
ce sujet
in order
sur
to discuss all
la
these
projection du Maroc,
subjects on the
sa
forecast
résilience, son
of
émergence
Morocco,
et son
resilience,
ambition,
emerging
six panélistes
Morocco and
exceptionnels,
its
certains nous
big
font passer de
ambitions. We
loin.
have panels
Je
who
les
came,
remercie
some
d'être
of
venus
them came
jusqu'à
from
Dubaï pour
really
partager avec
far
nous ce
to
moment
Dubai to share with us
pour
this
témoigner
moment
de
and to
l'empreinte de leur
also
entreprise dans notre
witness
pays.
the
Ce qui était important
footprint
pour
of
nous
the
tous, c'est de ne pas
enterprise of our
demander que de
country,
l'amour,
which
mais
is
de donner
very important today will not only give you love, but approve of love and show you the history, the enterprises who have invested in services and industry, and to be all this while mixing them with the national actors, national players who have mobilized their efforts to develop our country. My first question will be for you, Lamia Tazi. The national community and many of us have discovered in July and under the Royal Palace Office, where you signed the convention between you and a large Asian partner for the fabrication of vaccines. It's also it's showing modernity because Morocco has vaccinated 60% of its population. I have a question because you are a major player in this strategic industry, which is medicine, and the crisis that we went through has showcased that this sector is very important. There were no rupture in Morocco. All the medicines are available, especially among national players. What lessons have you learned throughout these 18 months, and what are the perspectives for the health sector? Remember that last Wednesday, the king has talked about sovereignty in Morocco. And you, Lamia Tazi, who are in the forefront of these questions, especially related to the health sectors, what are the perspectives and what are the lessons learned? The interpreter would like to apologize because the sound is very low. Unfortunately, we are unable to hear the speaker. The interpreter would like to apologize as we cannot hear the speaker. We're unable to translate right now because we cannot hear the speaker, so our apologies.
Faisant partie de plusieurs industries et agile. Elle est résiliente et elle est innovante. J'aimerais aussi rajouter qu'au-delà de livrer le marché, le Maroc a fait preuve aussi d'une créativité exemplaire, vu qu'à côté de tous les médicaments que nous sommes en train de fabriquer aujourd'hui et qui représentent à peu près 60% de la demande, dont 40% restent importés et 60% sont fabriqués, le Maroc a rapidement mis en place de la fabrication de certains produits et spécialement des dispositifs médicaux comme le kit de dépistage du Covid, comme les masques, etc. Donc ça montre aussi une quatrième qualité qui est donc ce Maroc innovant et créatif.
Merci Lamia Tazi. Donc je disais au démarrage de votre intervention que vous étiez une silhouette, mais là on vient d'avoir la démonstration que vous étiez aussi une voix, parce que vous avez réussi à parler sans micro pour le début. Donc merci beaucoup d'avoir partagé avec nous ces éléments-là. Alors, Mehdi Tiazi, vous aussi, quelque part, vous êtes arrivé dans l'actualité nationale en ce début janvier 2020, juste avant l'une des plus grandes pandémies qu'ait connue le Maroc depuis 3 siècles. Donc, vous arrivez pour conduire aux côtés du président Chakib El Haj de la Confédération générale des entreprises du Maroc. Et puis, arrive cette séquence totalement inattendue, ce signe noir. Quel regard portez-vous sur la séquence que vient de passer notre pays et comment vous, le secteur privé, avez organisé la communauté de destin avec la force publique pour pouvoir contrer la pandémie et permettre à notre pays de donner du futur au présent?
Écoutez, on a...
Our country went through and what will you do? What have you done in order to fight against the pandemic? Listen, we...
pour débattre d'un certain nombre de sujets. Et cette réunion s'est transformée en un premier comité de veille économique. Et je crois que la première chose que le pays a fait de bien, c'est que...
So what the country has done is we were able to adapt the capacities of the response capacities in order to take major decisions. Usually, the decisions would have to go through a long process. So we this has allowed us to deploy all the efforts, but during 3 months, and we were able to respond to all the citizens in a formal and informal way. So even people who were working in an undeclared market, these 4,000 houses who were able to benefit from the aid and the help. When it comes to the north side of the country, we were highly implicated at all levels in defining the responses in order to keep the production throughout the crisis. This has allowed us to go back to normal, slowly but surely, of course. However, every enterprise that had to close during 2020 and until now, the rates are very low. Why? Because they had support, mechanism of support, like all the personnel have received help, allocation, guaranteeing loans by the banking sector. So we have, so no one was made redundant, and now they are back to their work. So I think that beyond all this, what we need to keep in mind is that this pandemic has allowed us to discover the reaction capacities and other capacities that we didn't know we were able before or we had before. And for us, this is, I think, the biggest takeaway of this pandemic. Thank you so much, Mehdi. Candace, you have opened the international sequence, and it's such a pleasure to talk about the special characteristic of Morocco, inclusion, digital, women. What are your point of views, especially for the last 2 months? I'm happy that it's Sunday. Thank you for the question, Abdel Malik. It was very fascinating to see the reaction, the response, and also the humanity, the response of the humanity during this crisis, which goes beyond the resilience of the value chain, the capacity to create innovation, to be innovative, especially as a citizen, and the reaction that we have seen, not only resisting to the virus, but also protecting people. And beyond the steps, we had some actions of the government. So this resilience, especially when it comes to the value chain in the medical sector, the safety index, and we were able to have the 24th place in the world. This has given us a lot of reassurance, and it's really important to see that this pandemic was a blessing in disguise, especially I don't know if there is a link, a cause and a link, but there's a correlation between the dynamism of the digital and the partnership that we were able to have with Portnet in the private sector. with Cisco, which continues now. So I think what you said is we had this leap, digital leapfrog, to that pushed Morocco to mobilize all the efforts in order to improve in the digital world and to become an e-government. Yes, of course. And we can see the positive effects nowadays, not only through the government, but through all the programs that were established to support the entrepreneurs, the development, the democratization of the different entities. Those were needed anyway, and they need our support. It is affecting the population, women, children. We will go back. You spoke about culture, but I know that the portfolio is important, but to nourish your heart is also important. Candace, you spoke about a very important subject. And Mr. Bordeaux, I'm going to you now. It's not only important, it's vital, because your enterprise is located in Africa and the Middle East. It's a large global group. It's well known in Morocco because of his services in Rabat and Tanger, but you spoke about different sectors. How can your enterprise, and this is what's really important to us, how can a multinational with headquarters in Morocco has confronted the pandemic, and can you speak about your footprint in Morocco and your very particular. So thank you so much. It's an honor, and I'm really happy to be here and to participate in this panel. 2 years ago, the planet went through a world crisis, and Morocco was an example, a model in managing this crisis. I am proud today of the engagement and the commitment our teams in Amendis and Rial in Morocco throughout this health crisis by their devotion, by their commitment, and they became the real heroes, the real daily heroes in Morocco to ensure the essential services, water, electricity, and medication. So in this crisis moment, population counts on us. The medical professionals, the authorities were counting on us, and we were trying to organize ourselves in to respond to everyone. Mobilizing the teams were amazing and allowed us not to add another crisis to the health crisis. I'm sure there are some confrontation, there are some challenges. How did you treat water? There were no boats. You needed to find pragmatic solutions. Yes, of course. It's the work of the teams who are managing the Chouette Nesser. It's our work. It's also 20 years of presence in Morocco of Veolia through Amendis, 400,000 collaborators serving in Rabat, Salé, Tanger. It's our job. We're only doing our job. Thank you so much. We spoke about essential services, and now I'm going to go to the president. We will talk about agro nutrition and things that are affecting. Of course, resilience is good, but we are at a very challenging moment. COVID has put your industry under pressure, especially when we had to go through confinement, when we closed the borders. How did you confront the pandemic? How did you manage, and what are the lessons learned? Thank you so much, Mr. Alawi, for allowing me to participate. I know it's very difficult, but I like to go back to my notes. I have to say that the vocation is the raison d'être of our enterprise, and we were able to showcase a great resilience, although there are no missions in Morocco, but we work in this dynamic that is maybe allowing us to be and to incarnate and continue to incarnate an economical model to improve our position to serve the general interest for the years to come. The COVID-19 crisis and is here to stay. It continues to impact us, but it reminded us clearly that all our efforts need to integrate the climatic transition, social excellence, and sustainability. To adopt these approaches will allow us, of course, some revenues, but for Diana Holding, we were able to confront the difficulties, to the challenges, and the feelings that were shared by all other enterprises. Of course, you said something very important. We are here in a congregation of the private sector actors. You just said we need to, of course, go back to normal, and we need to start being productive. In the second sequence, we will talk about the new model of development and the ambitions for Morocco. Mama Soudouva, how are you? I have to say, we are very happy to have you today because you are emblematic of the historical discourse or speech of His Majesty, who says Africa needs to trust Africa. So I'd like to salute all the head of states who came, and I would like to congratulate you for being the director for all the MENA region. Alstom is has boarded the train, I think the fast train that's going to go through Africa. We think that we are the center of the world, but we had a confirmation not a long time ago, and we knew that the first people, the first person on the earth was coming from Morocco. So we are very happy to have you, and we would like to ask you to talk about Alstom. Alstom is a Moroccan enterprise who is known to have fabricated the LGV, so this fast train. Can you talk to us about your ambitions and your footprint in Morocco? Thank you so much. I'd like to join my friend Philippe and to say that I am honored to be a member of this panel. So, Alstom in Morocco is a history. We are in the kingdom for the past 100 years, and we had the chance to work with the authorities in the construction of the infrastructures linked to the mobility throughout the country. And our project is emblematic, is a very big, because the first fast train is Moroccan, African and Moroccan. So I'd like to add here that for Alstom, Morocco is a major country, because today, and with the teams of Nourdil Ghalmi present here, we have a factory that builds electrical equipment for all the trains of Alstom. So in Morocco, we have a world center of excellence on very advanced technologies. A train can go up to 100 kilometers, 1 kilometer of cable by meter of trains. So imagine how big, imagine how complex, imagine how sophisticated these equipments are. And today, with our Moroccan partners, with service providers, we have 400 million of euros in export. And only for Alstom, we have 400 people in Fez, majority of women. And today, we wish to continue using all the capacities of the human capacities, industrial capacities, but also the willingness of the authorities to continue investing in sustainable mobility and green mobility, not only to contribute in these policies, but also to consolidate our presence. And with a human personnel that comes from Morocco, so your boss for Morocco is Moroccan. Africa needs to trust Africa is a reality in Morocco. Of course, it's a reality in Morocco. And moreover, in the countries where we operate, and this is clearly translated by not only the managing team, but also the technical teams who not only contribute to the different activities throughout the country, but also are a world chain, because we are located in more than 70 countries, and I have said our equipment are delivered in UAE, USA, Europe, and teams from Morocco come to support the construction or the maintenance of the trains when there is a problem. Ladies and gentlemen, we have just finished the first sequence who showcased how the Morocco reacted for the past 18 years, what are the challenges that we faced. And I would like to go back to the French poet Laurent Grenier and say thank you for all the people who were present here and other who were not here. And we have some testimonials from many leaders. One of them has sent a video, and I would like to share it with you. I'll ask the team to share it, please.
Here at Boeing, we are very proud of our longstanding partnership with the Kingdom of Morocco, a relationship that stretches back over five decades. In 2001, we worked together to create one of the first players in the Moroccan aviation industry as we joined forces with Safran and Royal Air Maroc to create Matisse Aerospace. This joint venture aligned well with the bold vision of His Majesty King Mohammed VI to position Morocco as a global aviation player. The strong support and the commitment explain why the local aerospace sector has expanded over this past 20 years, growing from around 10 companies to nearly 140 in annual turnover of $1.7 billion in exports. Building on our commitment to the aerospace ecosystem in Morocco and the highly skilled workforce there, we entered into an MOU with the Kingdom in 2016. This MOU has proven to be a great success as we have added 11 suppliers, including two suppliers to Boeing. One of these suppliers, TDM, is the first Moroccan-owned aerospace supplier, a great achievement in a highly competitive aerospace industry. These early successes have demonstrated that the Kingdom of Morocco is a best value country that sets it apart from many. We believe that together we can address challenges in global aviation and support the long-term growth objectives of Morocco and at Boeing. Thank you for your partnership, and we look forward to building a stronger future together.
Bonjour. Le Maroc est un partenaire historique de Renault Group. C'est un pays à haut potentiel qui est aujourd'hui dans le top 5 de nos pays industriels et dans le top 15 des ventes mondiales du groupe. Le Royaume est aussi clairement un des piliers de notre plan stratégique Renaultution. Et avec ce plan, nous orientons l'activité du groupe vers plus de création de valeur. Nous avons les atouts pour y arriver et le Maroc certainement en fait partie. Je souhaite vous dire ma fierté et celle de nos équipes ici d'être le contributeur clé dans l'essor de l'industrie automobile au Maroc et d'avoir su saisir cette incroyable opportunité. J'aimerais souligner aussi l'importance de notre capital humain. Au-delà du fait que nous sommes la deuxième plus grande entreprise du Royaume en chiffre d'affaires, nous pouvons compter sur l'engagement de nos plus de 11 000 collaborateurs qui ont fait de cette industrie une véritable success story. Aujourd'hui, nous allons encore plus loin. Nous avons signé des accords ambitieux qui donnent une nouvelle impulsion à notre partenariat. Nous visons d'ici 2025 2,5 milliards d'euros de chiffre d'affaires en sourcing local et à terme 3 milliards d'euros et 80% d'intégration. Nous avançons en fait déjà en ligne avec nos objectifs parce qu'en début d'année 2021, nous avions déjà dépassé la barre des 60% de taux d'intégration locale. C'est aussi le coup d'envoi pour moi d'une nouvelle dynamique industrielle. Nous préparons l'industrialisation de nouveaux véhicules pour les marques Renault et la marque Dacia. dans les deux sites marocains du groupe. Ces véhicules incluront progressivement les technologies aussi de électrification de Renault. Et c'est avec une grande fierté qu'on dévoile la première Dacia Sandero fabriquée à la Somaca. Enfin, le Maroc a fait le choix stratégique de développer ses énergies renouvelables et de réduire son empreinte carbone. Ce projet de décarbonisation permettra aux industries de gagner en compétitivité. Ce sera un élément structurant dans les années à venir et c'est totalement en phase avec notre vision. La confiance est réellement ce qui structure la relation entre le royaume et le groupe, ce qui en fait une relation d'exception. La vision de Sa Majesté le roi Mohamed VI de développer cette activité dans le royaume, appuyée par le plan d'accélération industrielle en 2014, a positionné le royaume comme un acteur important dans la filière automobile mondiale.
Mesdames et messieurs, bonjour. Je me souviens encore de la cérémonie où, en 2015, avec Sa Majesté, nous avons signé l'accord de coopération entre le Royaume du Maroc et le groupe PSA. C'était un moment structurant, un moment fondateur. Depuis ce jour, avec le ministre El Alami, nous avons parcouru un très beau chemin, que nous continuons d'ailleurs aujourd'hui à parcourir. Un chemin de collaboration, un chemin de développement du tissu automobile au Maroc avec notre usine de Kenitra, mais surtout l'ensemble des fournisseurs qui nous accompagnent pour produire la magnifique Peugeot 208 dans cette usine. Nous avons travaillé très intensément pour développer le tissu fournisseur, pour faire en sorte que la valeur ajoutée, la technologie nécessaire pour ce magnifique véhicule soit présente au Royaume du Maroc. Et je peux dire que les résultats que nous obtenons aujourd'hui, à la fois dans notre usine, mais grâce aussi à l'ensemble de nos partenaires et nos fournisseurs, le résultat est à la hauteur des attentes. Nous savons que notre industrie est extrêmement compétitive, que jamais nous ne pouvons arrêter de travailler pour améliorer la qualité, pour réduire les coûts, pour être au rendez-vous de la fourniture des pièces au bon moment dans l'usine. Mais je peux ici attester du fait que ce travail profond, ce travail intense que nous avons développé avec le ministre El Alami, il produit ses effets. Nous sommes en mouvement, nous sommes en train d'avancer vers l'avenir. Et je veux ici simplement exprimer la satisfaction de ce qui est maintenant le groupe Stellantis, puisque comme vous le savez, depuis PSA a aussi traversé des moments structurants avec sa fusion avec le groupe FCA. Voilà ce que je voulais témoigner aujourd'hui auprès de vous.
Mesdames et messieurs, comme vous l'avez vu,
ladies and gentlemen, as you have seen, and I think if a young Morocco born in 2010, if we have told him that by 2021 we will be talking about production numbers that will go up to six digits, he would not believe. But before moving to the next panel, I'd like to ask you to please applause the panelists, who were here present, and I would like to please thank them for their magnificent work. In the first sequence, we were gonna talk about Janet Jackson and say, "What have you done to me lately? What has happened in Morocco?" Lamia Tiazi, everyone is talking about these major change of world chain of value chain. Everyone's talking about the medical sector and the changes. How do you see the modification of the value chain in a context that is more towards the multinational? What role will Morocco be playing? What role our industry can play in order to maximize the profits and the present in this industry? Well, Morocco is not only geographically well placed, but I think that technically, on the technical side, whether it's in the north or in the south, it's also well placed. I have to talk about the pharmaceutical industry, which is a strategic industry, and this is thanks to the vision of His Majesty, and this is what he also emphasized last week. Last week, also, His Majesty spoke about the security when it comes to the medical sector. And it has pushed us to say that if we are here today, it's because of his wise vision, and we are happy and proud to follow his vision. Now, the sectors are many, and they were not only identified and well-structured thanks to the acceleration plans since 2015, and we belong to CSMD, with whom we worked very well and identified the different sectors. But the role of the hub that Morocco is playing and that we want to present today has double meanings. You said already, and we know countries that are not very far from Morocco in the south of Europe who suffered shortages in medicine. It was not the case for Morocco, and today there were many questions asked. How can we attract industries, especially chemistry? Chemistry today has maybe disappeared from Europe, and it's a bit polluting. I don't think the reason was the pollution. It was the economy, and of course, it's polluting. Morocco is happy and ready to face these challenges, because not only our economy is good, but the climate is good. We are in renewable energy for the past years. We can relocalize certain products in fabrication, in co-development. Morocco today is a great transformer. Research is still a sector that needs to be developed, and I hope that with this spirit of innovation that has struck us all, and the hub towards the African continent, as we can see it, we can represent that hub towards Africa. It's very important to say today, so the climate is there. We have already started a transfer of technology towards some countries. It's very important to continue in this way, and we need to see Africa shining. The ambition is clear: hub in the medical industry towards Africa, towards other countries. Yes, and the place is vacant. There is a vacant place, but I'm going to go more towards Morocco. SMDs, NMDs, what are these acronyms? We can say NMD for new model of development, and Moroccans understand very quickly what are we talking about. So this new model of development, and how can we merge these two sequences, the strategy or the strategic, which is the creation of job, the protection of society, and the participation of the state. How can we link these two sectors together? How can we go more towards deployment or establishment? I think that we are working on the long term. So first of all, from 2000 to 2020, we built the infrastructure with green energy, 2,000 kilometers of roads, ports like the ports of Tangier, etc. This has allowed us to have more, of course, all the good governance ingredients, especially when it comes to competition. So this allows us to maybe welcome and big enterprises like Renault, like Peugeot, and other manufacturers. we so you have the legal framework. Yes, of course, we have all the infrastructures to welcome these countries, these models and these infrastructure. The new model of development that was commanded by His Majesty's and need to be deployed as soon as possible. So it's it goes from 2020 to 2030, and it has some clear targets to the investment, the strategy of the state towards productive industries that are beneficial for Morocco. And social protection, simplifying the administrational procedures, the investment, and also transformation of the central bank and the rationalization of different state entities. So this new models has as priority to have like a great energy, 0.05, and green energy in the 5 years to come. So on the second phase that comes 20 years after the first one, we'll talk about the long terms, or will fix the priorities, the long term priorities for the Morocco, 15 years, and this cap needs to be done on elements that are less tangible and more important, generalizing the allocation and the family allocation, road works, infrastructure, sustainable development, especially for the citizen. I'm sorry, it's a lot of things, a lot of ideas. What you're saying is that Morocco, that has been built post-independence, is becoming the coder country? Are we going towards this generation of immaterial infrastructure? So is this the new challenge? Yes, of course, we have great examples on this. And I think that some of us understood this at early stages, and the President Terab has a great vision on that subject. I don't know if you had the opportunity to visit the University 1337, and in 6 months we have quantities of engineers, a number of engineers who are really experts in IT. And that's very impressive. To continue on that subject, Condas, we're talking about the we spoke about the material things, but what are we talking about? Are we talking about equalities, the reforms of the personal status, which was a very difficult reform? It took 9 months to be established, and we had to redraft the new legislation. But this immaterial, or this these subjects that are being highly discussed in Morocco, what do you think? I think that in Morocco, and as Kofi Annan said previously, invest in women development is investing in development of a whole nation, because it's a great force, and the revenues can be major. It's like families will get the revenues, family will get the benefits, because women have the professional experience and have the professional know-how. The digital in this context has great potential at more than one level. Women development and women empowerment is very important, especially in different societies. When I was in Cameroon, the fact of having a significant number of women leaders showed us or allowed us to overcome lots of problems like discrimination, and the performance was amazing, and we even created a movement in this in the young students in the country. they were working in a very professional environment that allowed them to express themselves and to be empowered. The importance of digital in order to accelerate this process is a major priority. And before creating my own enterprise, I was working in the PR, and I was covering sub-Saharan Africa, and it's the internet that allowed me to educate myself and to establish a career. So I went through a lot of exams, and I discovered that you need to study hard to succeed. And I succeeded to get also great jobs and great positions. I worked with a lot of recruiters at later stages and many entrepreneurs, and it was Bouti who allowed me to develop my network, to develop my circle, and to also convey my knowledge to men and women who are looking to improve themselves. So do you think that digital is a major key player in the improvement of society? Of course it is. If all the infrastructure are not in place, nothing can happen. So we have to have electricity, we have to have access to education, we have to have access to internet, we have to be of a certain age. But there's also a willingness, a public willingness, and a responsibility. We need to also have the skills, especially in marginalized groups. All these are components. We saw the major challenges, the inequalities, but there's also the elephant in the room, the ecological transition, which is for Morocco, who is doing a lot of commerce with Europe and is going through a transformation on the ecology side. It's a great transformation for Morocco. And it's coming to inspire all enterprises, who some of them were leaders. How do you see the outlooks for the future, and what are the challenges for your company? And globally, what are your new ambitions for Morocco's? I think that Morocco has also done, has already done ambitious reform in order to ensure the transition towards a green economy. We have the most beautiful of ambitions, which is to succeed together. To succeed together in this transition, in this, it is our reason to be. Moroccan countries are contributing to the development of the continent. They need to be sustainable cities, and under the leadership of His Majesty, who fixed a cap of ecological ambitions and who wishes to drive Morocco to be the green hub. He has an ambitious strategy, and he wanted to make sure that we have a green economy. We need to manage our resources, and this will need to improve the efficiencies, especially in terms of electricity and power. When you the chef or the head of Renault spoke, you were smiling. Can we know why were you smiling? I will come back to this. But I have to tell you that we have the skills, we have the tools, and we can do it. We need the industrial development, and it can happen. We need to remove plastic. We have today a project to build a recycling factory. So this is a very ambitious project. We need to stop using the bottles, even the soda bottles that we wish to recycle, in order to create or to give them another life, or maybe a third life, in order not to consume gas. It's also decarbonization. We're trying to manage or to produce electricity based on residues of ZUZ, produced metal, from natural gas, from waste, in order to allow buses to function, or like the factory of Renault in Tanger. And thanks to the teams of Veolia, we built the first factory with zero emission of CO2. Those are just examples, just to show you the energetical mix. We have realities. It's not only theories. But I'm also thinking about the new smart cities. What we need to do, and how can we reuse, how can we use the reuse? There is a certain barrier that we need to overcome, and that barrier only very few countries were able to overcome it, like Namibia, for example. Today in Morocco, using the reused stuff is a reality to produce industrial water or agricultural water. We can do it in Rabat. I think many people who visited Rabat say that it looks like Geneva, and 80% of the water used for the irrigation, yes, it's water to whom we give a second life after it was being used in houses. But I'd like to also to insist that these are indispensable steps that we are taking to develop the kingdom. The environment footprint, is very important. We need to lower our emission if we want to continue to export. All this needs certain number of investment to adapt to this new paradigm. But in order to be able to achieve it, we need a factor of differentiation, especially when it comes to competitiveness. Circular economies are a reality in Morocco, and we are here to make sure that Morocco will win this challenge. So these questions of ecological transition, you are in the forefront, you are in the heart, because your company is in charge to connect the natural element. We do some transformation and we go through industrial processes. How do you see the evolution of your sector in Morocco, especially with these new ecological constraints and a logistic constraint? We're not talking too much about the logistics, but they are there, but also the new opportunities that exist with the new model of development. It's a question that needs some time, so please allow me some time. The ecology depends on human beings, and we need to preserve the harmony in our ecosystem. So it's not a constraint, it's not a challenge, it's an opportunity that we need to seize, especially for a sector like ours, where our job is to connect and harmonize elements. We are talking about precious resources, water, and the planet that are at the origin of our group, and we add human talent, technology, in order to have a product that will add some value. So we try to combine the different elements, and we are very careful about the environment. This is pushing us to always keep on improving our processes. When it comes to ecology, it's the biggest challenge of the moment, especially in the maritime sector, the transportation in the maritime sector. So this comes with another problem, the packing problem, which Sicubert, which allows us also sometimes some growth. However, what are the social data to allow us to develop? What are we doing to integrate youth? What are we doing also for women empowerment? The consequences of the world crisis is forcing us and forcing all the economical sector to be more resilient. And in order to link this to the future, we need to also examine this logistic question. Morocco has a unique capacity to be in the Atlantic and in the Mediterranean at the same time, to go through the Atlantic, especially when it comes to maritime transportation for the upcoming years. We don't know what's going to happen for Tangemed yet. When it comes to opportunity, the new model of development is a very ambitious horizon to which I would like to contribute, because it's capitalizing on the forces of Morocco. Social protection is touching each and every one of us, because in the heart of our company, it is one major preoccupation. We are always keen on keeping the human capital. And just like our founder has always said, the only richness, the real richness are the human resources. So our group is has never neglected human resources. And we have also always taken the measures and given example and also made sure that our personnel is well paid. I think what's important is we have family group represented in this panel. They are the heartbeat of Moroccan economy, and they have developed this economy. There is a certain signature, which is a willingness for the long term. We spoke about logistic, we spoke about ecology. It's music to your ears. It's also a mean to move with taking into consideration the weather, the climate, and since 7 months, Morocco and China have no links. So these subjects that you know by heart, what is the vision that you have of the evolution of sustainable mobility, especially that the questions are recurrent? How are we going to take advantage of these new talents? And you are at home here at Expo, because you manufactured the train that links Dubai. Yes, of course, it will reduce the distance for those who are asking questions on how to move around Expo. So how are you going to link mobility, ecological transition, and development in Morocco? I think that Morocco has extremely implemented with a lot of well-defined structures, the vision of the king in the development, in the global development of infrastructure. When it comes to maritime transport, as you know, the Moroccan cities like Casablanca, like Rabat, have developed through the trams some urban mobility system that are very efficient, that are very simple, and that are connecting the city. This has not only impact on the ecology, but on how to facilitate the movement of the citizens. They can go to work, they can go to universities, they can visit museums or just go out. So for us, it's more of a it's not a sector, an activity sector, but a transformation to which we are contributing along with the local authorities and the national authorities in Morocco. And I'd like to second what Ms. Lamiatasi said. If we go through the shock the humanity went through with COVID, today we need to relocalize. We need to change. And from that perspective, the diversity of the different capacities and investments that Morocco has done, especially in the transportation, whether in automotive or maritime transportation, has attracted and the development of skills linked to the mobility. It's a very important factor because the first investment beyond infrastructure is the human capital. It's the Moroccan engineers, it's these men and women who have studied in Morocco and in other countries, and we have a responsibility towards these people that goes beyond the policies, beyond the economy. Morocco is responsible to help and to host the development of other countries of the continent in this know-how. And Morocco is playing a great role in this field. I think and I consider that it's very important that beyond what we're talking about, the strategy and the vision of Morocco, the openness and the responsibility that Morocco has towards the other countries of the continent. So it's the catalyst of the co-development in Africa. No, not only an example. Morocco is not only an example. It's a major player. There are very few countries in the continent that have this vision, these policies of openness and investment in the other African countries. We've seen it through the financial sector, insurance, industry, agriculture. And I think, I would say, it's a need, but also a responsibility that is well showcased from the highest authority, which is His Majesty the King, to all the Moroccan institutions. To close this session, I'd like to ask you the same question. And I'd like to ask you to take 1 minute and 1 minute only to answer. Today, do you think the time for Morocco to access the emerging markets has come? I think that, in fact, Morocco needs to grab this opportunity and also capitalize or take advantage of his experience, not to commit the same mistakes, and move forward. And I'd like to ask you, is that the last question? Yes, I know that you have some time constraint. I would like to also send some messages. So in a world where strategic agility is the new alpha and omega of a new enterprise, I don't think that we can oppose these two dimensions. Men is at the image of the Morocco, the new Morocco who is uniting us. We have a great track records, and under the vision of His Highness the King, who made a symbol of these unique capacities and paved the way towards the future. Today, more than ever, we need to ensure the food security and under the visionary leader of His Majesty, the King Mohammed VI. And after the pandemic, we have new technologies offering a great potential to Morocco, especially through artificial intelligence, but without forgetting the richness that we have. And with the crisis that we are going through, the change of paradigms, which will allow us to implement new measures in order to tackle the new challenges and all the forms of malnutrition, climate change, restoration of our ecosystem, solidarity and complementarity from the state, from north to south, east to west. So the answer is yes, it is time for Morocco. You said something that I really liked. So we need to invest on the long term. We need to give future to the present when it comes to strategy. So Philippe, for you who are a good or a privileged observer, is it now time, is time for Morocco to shine? Yes. To be very short, yes. Morocco is a center of expertise who has benefited a lot than other countries where Veolia is present. I'm going to give you a very fast example. 10 days ago, Veolia won the contract for the service of water in Riyadh area in Saudi Arabia, the biggest contract in the world. 42 experts in Veolia need to leave in 2 months to manage this contract. And do you know who were the four candidates who said we want to go? Four Moroccan experts from Veolia. The first four who want to go discover, who want to share their expertise with their colleagues in Saudi. So that's why I am convinced that with the competence, with the skills of our teams, and with the impulsion that was launched by His Majesty, we will together win and we will transform. Lamia, you have a great responsibility because part of the vaccines, I'm preparing these syringes. So I'm going to put a red cross on your front head. So I can only be positive because I imagine that each one of us has maybe sacrificed a lot. We are happy. It's already positive. We're traveling. We're going out. We're eating at some restaurants. So first African country to fabricate the vaccine, to produce vaccine, a new government, a youth, new dynamics. So we need to work. We proved that we were able, but I think that we need to continue to work nonstop in order to continue the efforts. Mehdi, what is your personal touch? If you have known that you needed to confront such a cyclone, would you have gone? It's a question that many people would ask themselves, because do we really want to go through this challenge? But 2 years ago, when you have presented yourself as a candidate, were you thinking about this? Should I answer for both of us? Yes, of course. We had the chance to live the chance. Okay. The chance to be useful during this period, because we had a great impact, and it was important. To answer your question, of course, we are in a very important moment in Morocco because the stars are aligned. And earlier on, I spoke about what we have established throughout the past 20 years, and which is the layer on which we will be able to build. We have a new government, a young government, and someone said they are political technocrats. I think we are emerging from the crisis, and these are maybe times where growth will be at its best, and we want to play a major role. So the example of Majorelle we spoke about this morning, which is great according to the world standard, 4 billion, is a signal that there is a certain enterprise that is 50% Moroccan who is being positioned on this intellectual know-how and is operating across the world. But there are others, especially when it comes to automotive and plane manufacturer. When it comes to Morocco, they are present at every tender. I know there are others like Serbia, Romania, Egypt. They are our competitors, but they don't choose to come to Morocco just to visit us, but they choose to come here because of our competitiveness, especially in terms of human resources, who is deploying a certain level of productivity that is the best in the world. And I think, yes, it is the world. It is the time for Morocco. So we have Condas. When it comes to diversity, I'm going to say yes, yes, and it is time for Morocco, and it could be the time for Morocco and Africa as well, as to conquer the world. They need to leverage on entrepreneurship, on technologies, not only to position us as a world hub, but to create the Silicon Valley, the Silicon Desert. We have a lot of advantages on that front because of some agencies like ADDs that are very dynamic, the quality of infrastructure, and the advantage of quality price, the connection in Morocco, and Morocco has a pan-African talent that has is great. We have also the Francophones who are well educated, who will play a great role, who are able to create some technical assistance and create some evolution of digital, some entrepreneuria, Africa and Morocco together. So, Mr. Soufougara, you have the last word. What do you think about the Morocco nowadays? We have proven during this session that Morocco has the capacity to anticipate. So do you think that it is time for Morocco? It's very difficult to say no, but it's also it's a simple truth. It will be like the Grand Slam, because all the panel has agreed or were positive. But what's very important for me is, and as Candace has mentioned, it's the time for Morocco and the time for Africa. For me, it's one of the most important aspects of this strategy that Morocco has adopted, because offering capacities and solutions in a world economy with a continental presence, so we are the only country that was able to do it. Many have dreamed about it, many have tried it, but today we can clearly and proudly say that Morocco is the one who's going to do it. Thank you so much. And I think that the last symbol of our modernity is that we are able to finish a panel on time. We were supposed to finish at 7:30. Please, I'd like to thank my panelists. So today, at 2050, you can remunerate the efforts of CGM Morocco by watching a great and exceptional animation on Burj Khalifa, and it's a great pride for all of us Moroccan to be at the expo and to have this great opportunity to eliminate the monument that is the most emblematic and with the colors of our country. Thank you so much and have a great evening.